This is Adolf. Welcome to video lecture series on the course of building construction. In this video, under the masonry materials, we are going to see about mortars. So the content of these videos are introduction, classification of mortar, what are the functions of mortar, what are the good properties of a good mortar, and what are the proportions of a mortar, and finally testing of mortar. Introduction. The term mortar is used to indicate a paste prepared by adding required quantity of water to a mixture of binding material like cement or lime and fine aggregates like sand. The two components of mortar, namely the binding materials and fine aggregates, are sometimes referred to as the matrix. The durability, quality, and strength of mortar will mainly depends on quantity and quality of the matrix. The combined effect of the two components of mortar is that the mass is able to bind the bricks or stone firmly. So let's see the classification of mortar. Mortar are classified on the basis of the following four types. One is bulk density. Second one is kind of binding materials. Third is nature of application. Fourth is special mortars. So let's see one by one. So based on bulk density, according to bulk density of mortar in dry state, the mortars are two types. One is heavy mortars, another one is lightweight mortars. So these heavy mortars are prepared from heavy quartz and it have a bulk density more than 1500 kg per meter cube. The lightweight mortars are prepared from light porous sand and it have bulk density less than 1500 kg per meter cube. This is based on kinds of binding material. According to the kinds of binding material, several factors such as expected working condition, hardening temperature, moisture content should be considered. The mortars are classified as the following categories. First one is lime mortar. In this mortar, lime is used as a binding material. So this lime may be a flat lime or hydraulic lime. So if we use flat lime, the proportion to the lime to sand will be 1:2 to 1:3 ratio. If you use hydraulic lime mortar, the proportion may be 1:2. Second is cement mortar. In this mortar, cement is used as a binding material. So in lime mortar, is in lime as a binding material. In cement mortar, cement is used as the binding material. Depending upon the strength required and importance of the work, the proportion of the cement to sand varies from 1:2 to 1:6 ratio. Next is gauged mortar or composite mortar. The process of adding cement to lime mortar to improve the quality of lime mortar, we call it as a gauging. So that type of mortar, it is called as gauged mortar. So it makes lime mortar economical, strong and dense. The usual proportion of cement to lime by volume is about 1:6 to 1:18 ratio. Next is mud mortar. The paste is prepared by mixing suitable clay soil with water. The soil which used for preparing mud mortar should be free from grass, pebbles, stones, etc. These are the cheapest mortars but weakest in strength. These mortars are used for brickwork of ordinary building and for plastering walls in rural areas. It's just based on nature of application, our mortars are classified into two categories. One is brick laying mortar, next is finishing mortar. So first, brick laying mortar. These mortars for brick laying are intended to be used for brickworks and walls. So depending upon the working condition and the type of construction, the composition of masonry mortars with respect to the kind of material is decided, binding material is decided. Next is finishing mortar. These mortars include common plastering work and mortars for developing architectural or ornamental effects. Generally, cement or lime is used as a binding material. But in bricklaying mortars, this binding material is decided based on the working condition, what are the type of construction, composition of masonry mortars. Next is special mortars. Under the special mortars, the first one is fire resistance mortar. This mortar is prepared by adding 1:2 ratio of aluminous cement with crushed powder of fire bricks. This fire resistant mortar used for fire brick lining furnace, oven and fireplaces with fire bricks. We will use these fire resistance mortar. Next is lightweight mortar. So these mortars is prepared by adding sawdust, wood powder to the lime or cement mortar for making these mortars as a soundproof material and heatproof material. Next type of special mortar is packing mortar. These special type of mortars possessing the properties of high homogeneity, and it have a capability of water resistance, and it can ability to form a solid waterproof plugs in cracks and voids of rock, and it can resist to subsoil water pressure. So these types of mortars are formed with cement sand, cement loam and cement sand loam mortars. These packing mortars are used to pack oil wells in the oil field. The next type of special mortar is sound absorbing mortar. These sound absorbing mortars are prepared with Portland sand, lime, gypsum, slag Portland cement as the binding material, and the aggregates or lightweight porous material such as pumice, cinders will be used. These sound absorbing mortars are used to reduce the noise level. Next is X-ray shielding mortars. These type of mortars is used for providing the plastering coat to walls and ceiling of X-ray cabinets. So this is a heavy mortar with bulk density over 2200 kg per meter cube is used. And the aggregates used in these mortars are obtained from heavy rocks, and suitable admixtures are added to enhance protective property of such a mortar. Functions of mortar. Mortars are used to bind together the bricks or stones in brick or stone masonry, and it is used to give a soft, even bed between different layers of brick or stone masonry for equal distribution of pressure over the bed, and it is used to fill up the spaces between bricks or stone for making wall tight, and used in concrete as a matrix, used in plastering work to hide the joints and to improve appearance, and used for molding and ornamental purpose. Properties of good mortar. Good mortar should have capable of developing good adhesion with the building unit, and it should be a workable, that means easily transport to the place of application, And good motor should have capable of retaining sufficient water during its application. And it should be sufficiently plastic. That means it can easily placed on the bed of the construction in the form of thin, smooth and uniform layer. And it should be durable and strong in itself on drying and hardening at the same time. It should not develop any cracks on drying. It should be economical to make without compromising of any of the qualities, and it should be capable of developing the designed stresses. So these are the properties of a good motor. Next is proportions of motor. So some common proportion of cement, lime and sand used for civil engineering works. So if you take masonry work in foundation and plinth, the cement mortar ratio is 1:6. That means 1 part of cement and 6 part of sand. Or if you take lime cement mortar, its ratios are 1 part of lime, 1 part of cement and 8 part of sand, or 1:1:7 or 1:1:6. If you take lime mortar for masonry in foundation and plinth, its ratio is 1:2 to 1:3. That means 1 part of lime, 2 part of sand, or 1 part of lime, 3 parts of sand. So, next is, if you use mortar in superstructure. So masonry in superstructures, for a single or two storied building, if you take cement mortar, its ratio is 1:6. If you take lime cement mortar, its ratio is 1:1:8. And if you take lime mortar, its ratio is ranges between 1:3 to 1:4. For a three-story building, cement mortar is 1:4 to 1:6, whereas lime cement mortar is 1:1:7. So if you go for a four-story building, cement mortar, for ground floor it is 1:3, for first and second floor it is 1:4, for third floor it is 1:6. So for plastering work, cement plaster is 1:4 to 1:6, lime plaster 1:2 to 1:3. So the first one, the ratio represents the binding material, and this last one, it represents the aggregate. So these are the various common proportions of mortar used in our civil engineering works. Testing of mortar. So in this testing of mortar, there are three tests are conducted. First one is crushing test or compressive strength test. So this crushing test is carried out on a mortar in the form of mold in a compressive testing machine. So once the mold is placed in the compressive testing machine, load will generally apply. So we have to note down the load at which the mold gets broken. So the crushing strength is equal to load by cross-sectional area. Let's see a video. It is clearly explained the procedure of crushing test or compressive strength test.
Compressive strength test of cement. The compressive strength is the basic important data required to be considered to choose the type of cement for the construction site. The compressive strength quality of any cement is controlled by the type and the degree of adulteration in cement. The test specimens are formed in the side length of 70.6 mm or 76 mm cubes. Generally, the specimens larger than this should not be made as cement shrinks and cracks. The temperature of water and test room should be 27 degrees plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius. The mixture of cement and standard sand in the proportion of 1:3 by weight is mixed dry with a trowel for 1 minute. Then add the water to form a standard consistency paste. The materials for each cube should be mixed separately. Generally, the quantities of cement, standard sand and water are 200 g, 600 g and p/4+3, respectively. Where p is equal to percentage of water required to produce a paste of standard consistency. The mix is filled in the mold completely with the cement paste and is placed on the vibration table. Vibrations are imparted for about 2 minutes at a speed of 12,000 plus or minus 400 rpm per minute. Similarly, 3 specimen cubes are prepared. The cubes are then removed from the molds and submerged in clean fresh water. After the while, the cubes are taken out for testing in a compression testing machine. The load is applied starting from zero at a rate of 35 Newton per square millimeters per minute. Note down the maximum load at which the cube fails. The compressive strength is calculated from the crushing load divided by the average area over which the load is applied. The result is expressed in Newton per millimeter square. Compressive strength is taken to be the average of the results of the 3 cubes.
Next is tensile strength test. So here we have to mold a mortar in a form of brick T. So which has a central cross sectional area as 38 mm by 38 mm. So here also we have to mold a mortar in a form of brickety. Then we have to install that brickety in the universal testing machine to find out the tensile strength of the test. Same procedures, but here instead of compression testing machine, we are using a universal testing machine. The tensile area, so after 24 hours we have to remove the briquette from the mold and immediately submerge the briquette in a fresh clean water. Then we have to take the briquette from the clean water and place the briquette in the chip of briquette tensile tester. This one is the briquette tensile tester, and we have to apply the pressure starting from zero at a rate of 0.7 Newton per mm square per 12 seconds. For every 12 seconds, the load will gradually increase by 0.7 Newton per mm square. So we have to note down the pressure at which briquette breaks. So we have to carry out this test for 6 moles to get the average load value. So once the average load value you can get, the tensile strength is equal to load by cross-sectional area. Next is adhesive test. So in this adhesive test, bricks are joined together with mortar to be tested. So see the side view. This is how the setup will be look like. So two bricks will join together by a mortar. The upper brick is suspended from an overhead support and a board is hung on the lower bricks. So a board will hung on the lower bricks and upper brick is a suspended from an overhead support. So we have to add a weight on the board in the lower brick till the bricks separate. So we have to note down which weight the bricks get separated. So once we know that, then we can find the adhesive strength. That adhesive strength is equal to load by contact area. So let's see a video showing the how to perform our adhesive test. These are the references you can follow. So in this video we covered introduction of motors, classification of motors. There are four categories: bulk density, kinds of binding material, next is nature of application, and special motors. Then we saw the functions of motor, properties of good motors, and proportions, common proportions used in the civil engineering. Then test on motor. Thank you.